fresh coffee and bagels too. A new day is waiting for us. We got lots of fun stuff to do. I take pride in ever working that day. Can't see the use of it anyway. Who can think I'm such a load of crap? Growing up is just a trap.
IQ&A.
I'm gonna do.
Sure, all you smell is just a tiny bit of burning hair.
That's lovely.
Because hair and teeth are actually made of.
Just hold shit. Still, we're gonna point a laser at your face.
Well, that's like what that Jeremy Hotz joke. He's like, I went in for laser eye surgery.
But
it's terrifying. You're not supposed to smell your eyes burning. Anyways, I was strong.
But it's great because she uses a special UV component that actually builds onto the tooth so it feels natural, it looks natural, it matches totally yellow the same. And then you can eat and drink immediately after.
Oh, that's okay. Good. That's cool.
Because I'm hungry.
Because for days after like I was injected, it would just throb and ache. And whenever I have to get numbed up, it numbs all the way up my entire face and down my neck and everything. And they say, oh, I'll disappear in 6 hours. It takes 18 for me.
Oh, wow.
Me, it goes away in 2 hours, but it sucks when it does because your face gets sore. I can actually feel the injection site and like
that's why I like my injection because it takes half the amount of time.
Yeah.
And
yeah. So I'm gonna start with her dentist.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, you feel all the vibrations and everything, but I'd rather deal with like the slightest bit.
For half an hour of that shit,
needles versus lasers.
I would. Well, yeah. Why not?
I'm not. Just the future in general.
We're in the future.
So, welcome to IQ Not Applicable. I'm Big Mike.
I don't like dealing with a prick in my mouth.
Yeah, right. I'm Big Mike.
That's true. But anyways,
I'm Alex.
And I'm Justin first.
So, speaking of dentists. Yeah, about half of it, yeah. So, speaking of.
Sorry.
Stop! Speaking of dentists and blood curdling screams, we are going to be talking about things that scare us this episode.
You know what? I had this. Sorry, one thing about dentists. Isn't it funny how you'll have your mouth open and it'll be working? They'll be like, so, how was your week?
Yeah!
I don't know how that. And they didn't understand it perfectly.
What was the weird fucking hilarious YouTube video? It's got this little monkey and he's pretending to be a dentist.
Right.
And he's got it. He's like inside the guy, other monkey's mouth, and he's like, so how's the other? Ah, please, sir, please don't talk while I'm in your.
Yeah, what the fuck? Then why are you talking to me?
What? Stop talking to me.
You want me to sign this shit up?
When they're working on my mouth, I'll keep my mouth open, but I just want them not to let me drown my own spit.
Yeah, exactly.
So basically, they say, like, raise your left hand if you're in pain. That's not the thing that's bothering me. The thing that bothers me is, like, I'll raise my hand, then I'll start tapping my throat. It's like, I'm drowning here.
It's like, I'm in pain from drowning.
No. It's weird. I can do it.
No,
when
it's
I
just
have to.
Do what?
Swallowing with your mouth open.
Yeah, there's no fucking gag reflex.
I have to use my tongue.
What do you mean?
To put it. Use your tongue. Cut it off, like let it drain into your throat, and then close with your tongue.
You got some talents, my friend. We'll talk later.
I do not have a gag reflex, but anyways.
That's a dick sucking technique right there. Man.
You're like a mutant, like, it's like, what would your mutant power be?
Sucking.
The sucker!
I broke Mikey.
No,
this is fucking.
It was
what does mute power be? Suck it, dick. Okay. I meant his name. What would his name be?
Sucker.
The Knob Goblin?
The Knob Goblin?
John Thomas.
John Thomas? What?
What?
No, that would be his alter ego. John Thomas, the Knob Goblin.
Oh my god. No. John Thomas?
It's another name for a dick. John Thomas.
It's yeah, like, quick Jean, come here. Like, Jean Grey's a lame name as we go up. It's like, Nightcrawler, come here. Wolverine, get over here. John Thomas, get over here.
Well, you heard what happened.
I guess we have Jean Grey, so it's not that weird. But
well, you have heard what happened to Captain America, right? Hmm. He quit being Captain America and passed that on to Falcon.
Yeah.
And then eventually that was passed on to Bucky. Or was it the other way around?
It was the other way around.
It went to Bucky, then it went to
yeah.
Falcon. But after that, he goes, I'm still going to be a superhero. And even Tony Stark was like, yeah. What are they going to call you? Steve Rogers? Oh, help me, Steve Rogers! Like, and then he got really old.
Yeah.
The serum kind of died out, and he went right old. It actually isn't a call.
Yeah.
It's like, quick, right. Run away, man!
Yeah, really. So, John Thomas here. What are you afraid of?
Me?
Dicks in the mouth?
What am I afraid of?
What's your?
Do you want my fucking list?
Okay, well, everybody is afraid of a different
things. We all have a list. Okay, top three.
Top three, yeah. Let's do top three. Good call, because this could be a while.
I have three that I can think of right now that is real. Number one.
Needles.
No, that one's actually not so much a fear as more of a discomfort now.
Okay.
It was a horrible fear. I used to run out
what
of
what if it was like 30 needles pointed at your face?
I'd be gone.
Saw where you gotta reach in for the key.
Oh, no. I'd be like, you can have a fucking key, let me die. Man. I'd rather die. But anyways, yeah. Number one, and something nobody really thinks about, is appendicitis.
Yeah, it's true. Anytime I have like a stomach ache, he was like,
is it coming on and off? Is it getting worse every time?
It's called a period cramp. Of course it comes on and off.
Yeah, but it doesn't get worse every time.
Of course it does.
Appendicitis? No, because appendicitis by the third
that
or fourth.
That'll also be a really lame part. The only guy that has a period.
Honestly, you've never had one of my period cramps.
No, I'm a dude.
Do you hear
thankfully,
that?
My penis doesn't.
That's another. That's another guy with a really bad mutant power. We should do a thing where people with really bad mutant powers. A guy who has a period. That's his mutant power.
Thank you, penis, for not bleeding once a month. Anyways.
Oh my god, my penis is bleeding.
Anyways, so appendicitis, why I'm afraid of that, though, is it's not an irrational fear.
But what would tampons look like to that?
Like, really long like this?
Look like a fucking sock.
I don't even want to think about that.
Just puts it over his
like
neck.
Cotton, like a...
Puts it over
his... It's like a pad.
Okay, yours sounds better than mine. Mine, I was injecting it in the pee hole. That's a lot more painful. I like your method better. Okay, sock over the wiener.
All right, back on track.
Let's get back on track. All right.
That is what scares me. Male tampons. Anyway, okay.
And it's good for people with bladder cancer. Anyways.
Fair enough. Anyway, okay.
No, the reason I'm afraid of appendicitis is...
It could kill you?
The fact that it can kill you in 24 hours. The other fact is that it's excessively painful. The other fact is a lot of people go, oh, just, ow, it's okay, just some cramping. I'll be fine in the morning. And then they're dead. Because the worst part is once the pain stops, you're fucked. It is now leaking toxins into your system and killing you. And you can survive from it, but it is like 90% you're going to die.
If you don't get to the hospital. Right away,
yeah. I saved a friend from it.
Yeah.
Graydon. I rushed him to the hospital because the whole day he kept walking around holding his side and going, fucking, he kept eating Tums. Oh, I'm having heartburn. It's heartburn.
That is also,
in your fucking lower.
That was also a symptom for a heart attack because, like.
Well, severe heartburn, yeah.
Well, because Candace's dad, like, because they saw some Tums on the table before he died of a heart attack, that they thought, okay, well, they're pretty sure he had a heart attack because a lot of things, when you're feeling the feeling of a heart attack, it feels like intense heartburn.
Yeah.
Which scared me sometimes when I eat a lot of tacos.
You ate a lot of tacos. It's kind of logical. No, my mom had the same thing for her heart attack.
Yeah, scary.
She was like, I'm going to go for a night. I'm going to a movie with Diane, which was her husband mother at the time. And she's like, I'm having a lot of heartburn, so I'm going to have some Tums and I'll drink some milk because that helps.
Mm-hmm.
And then, I got a call like half an hour later. She's in the hospital. She just had a heart attack.
Yes.
But anyways, appendicitis, because it's something, we'd have no use for the appendix.
Mm.
If they could just take it out of everyone, that would be smart, because then there would be less chance of
unnecessary surgery, though.
It is, but lately appendicitis has been getting crazy. It's been showing up a little more than usual. But anyways, the second fear is tornadoes.
Also legitimate.
And you notice how all my fears...
We have talked about this on a past episode.
It's all my fears are of things I can't control.
Yeah.
I can't control a fucking tornado. If it's coming, hide. That's about all you can do, and I hate that.
What's number one?
Number one was appendicitis, tornadoes, and then number three was... What's number three?
Asking her.
I don't know. I forgot what number three was.
Okay.
It's not needles. No, it's not needles. That used to be a fear. I used to run
giant spider-sized dogs.
No, I'd have no problem.
Oh, wait.
Giant dog-sized spiders.
That's not as frightening. That's
giant
cute,
dog-sized
actually.
Spiders
I can take 30
cute?
Dogs to work. Anyway. Giant spiders, dog-sized spiders.
I'd have no problem with that.
That's frightening.
At least I can find them a lot faster.
But if they're like, say a dog like running towards you down the street, you're like, shit, right?
That's
kind of scary.
Harry Potter bullshit right
yeah.
there.
But just
Jumanji.
Think of, Jumanji, yeah, fuck that. Okay, so like, just picture this, though. It's like you're walking down the street, you see a dog running at you, right? You're a little scared, right? You hide. Or you get wherever you can, right? But you see a giant spider, like, about that size running towards you down the street. I'm dead. I'm fucking dead. Because they can hop fences and shit, and they climb over. I'm dead.
I'm trying to think of what number three is, but I can't.
We'll come back to it.
Alex, name something you're afraid of.
I was in the CN Tower, and I was kind of forced to go onto the glass floor.
Oh, fuck yeah, I can't
do
that.
The thing is, I don't do heights.
I'm not a height person either. It's probably going
to
be too.
Whenever we were in a hotel,
I had to look out the window all the time. I loved it.
Yeah.
Well, I did eventually, but it took me, a day and a half to get used to it. Anything above 5 stories, I don't really go near the window at all.
So, you can't even, stand near a window, eh? See, I can look out a window. I can even go to a balcony.
It's
it
takes a while for me to get acclimated to it.
Right.
So it's like when you're in Edmonton, it took me a day and a half to 2 days before I could go near that window.
Right. Yeah. So yeah, you have a legitimate fear.
I would always basically say, Sam, go open the window, or Sam, go close the window.
Yeah, fair enough.
So,
yeah, see,
and I would always sleep on the inside of the room.
Oh, really? Holy, eh? Yeah, see me, I can look out a window, no problem, especially when
I went to the CN Tower, and I was kind of pushed and pulled, kind of nudged out onto it, so I was kind of just standing on the edge of it.
Yeah, you don't
and
do
then
that to someone scared of heights.
And so it's my mom wanted a picture. It's lay down and act like you're falling. I was no! And then some fucking asshole, I was 13 at the time, grabbed me and pulled me into the center, and
You freaked.
I freaked out.
Oh, I don't blame
you.
I
can't do it.
But, yeah, I don't blame you.
Hold up, I have a thing for this, because I don't have a fear of heights. I have a fear of falling and a fear of splattering on the ground, but no fear of heights. I know as long as I'm secure, I'm whatever, it's high. I could stand on one of those not the CN Tower, but one of those cell towers. I've always wanted to climb one, because I'm not afraid of the heights
itself.
Yeah,
I'm not that. I'm in between both of you.
But I will say this, I went on that glass floor. And your body definitely reacts without you wanting to. I stepped on it. My brain was you're falling. We're good.
Yeah. Immediately.
My brain was holy shit.
When I stepped on
it,
I got low. And I stopped.
Yeah. I get that way too. We go on a train bridge or something like that. My knees get
that was really stupid.
That was really stupid.
Yeah, but my knees just get super weak. I have a hard time holding myself up because it's I don't like being up here. It's not the height, it's the falling.
Even when we're on the train bridge, I'm always holding onto the banister constantly.
And I was longboarding down it without even a fucking care in the world on it.
Last
just the way we're different.
Last summer, I think it was me and who else was with me? I think it might have been Candace. But anyway, I was going up. And I can't do the steps.
the
see-through
train bridge
steps.
Your bane.
Yeah, yeah.
So for those of you who don't know, we live in a town called Saskatoon, Saskatchewan, Canada. And basically we have a train bridge. And it's over a weir, which, sort of.
It's a man-made little.
Dam thingy. So anyway, you go up these stairs and there's two sets of stairs. There's one set of stairs that's made out of wood
that's almost as old as the bridge itself.
Exactly. Yeah. So there's those ones. Then there's the newer steps. That have the see-through metal floor.
Yes.
I did that. I can't do it anymore.
I don't like them either.
Yeah, because I was but we did it a couple years ago. We were all there one time.
I can't help it.
Right? Yeah,
you can't.
If you look this, you're looking down at where you are.
Yeah, you're kind of if I don't look down, I'm going to go to fall through.
Exactly. Yeah. And that's the thing. So, I can't even go up the stair. I can't even go up those stairs anymore. I tell Candace, we have to cross the street. I can't do this. I can't go down the other way. And then as soon as I got up there, I just can't do it anymore. It sounds...
You have severe vertigo.
I do. It sounds like. Basically, I'm what my mom had with me. My mom had no problem with this, but as soon as she had me, mind you, I'm not pregnant, just fat. I can't. The older I get... I can't seem to handle it as much anymore. I get a sheer panic.
It's your body basically telling you, I'm not invincible anymore.
Yeah, but see,
I never used to have a problem with it until I started developing tits.
No,
I
know. Me too. But anyway.
But do you remember I climbed up the fucking I-beam on the side of the stairs?
Yeah, you're a fucking idiot.
But I'm literally hanging on this I-beam, toes up against it and holding on.
You're fucking crazy. No,
It was great.
I get the feeling of not just that I'm going to fall. I also get the feeling of I'm going to die before my kid grows up. Like, being a dad now, I get that feeling now, and I hate that. I hate it!
Do you know what gets me as one thing with the whole kids thing that your mom probably got? I try not to hover over my kids, but
right.
when they go near a ledge like that,
yeah,
and it's like, we go to even the mall here, the Midtown Mall,
yeah.
and they walk towards the edge to look over the side, and I can just feel it, I'm like,
like, you know they're okay, yeah. and whatever, it's like, but the fucker do that!
So,
yeah.
I don't know, it could be the rational fear of
parenthood.
Yeah.
And yeah,
that's my child's gonna get afraid, kind of helps build up on that there, too.
Mm-hmm.
It was actually the first thing that ever triggered an anxiety attack for me, besides 13 not understanding what was going on.
Right.
And then I was fine for the longest time, was being in a city which I have absolutely no idea where anything fucking is.
I
was supposed to be meeting with friends, which would be, I'm fine.
Yeah.
And getting off the plane and immediately getting a call saying that they weren't coming.
Oh,
and being like, I'm all by myself.
I'm by myself in a city where I have no idea what to do. The room that was booked does not have my name attached to it, so I have nowhere to stay.
Yeah, that's a pretty good fear for anyone.
Yeah, that's pretty
and
scary.
And so I sat in that airport for 6 hours on the phone with my dad because I didn't know what to fucking do.
Well, yeah, hey, that sounds very legitimate to me. Like, you're in a city, you don't know anybody.
I found a dark corner which was completely sheltered, because that's the thing, is like when you're having a panic attack,
yeah.
you find sheltered. Somewhere that's safe.
That's right.
So it's either I lock myself in the bathroom, or I find a deserted corner. So I found the corner which was just getting like recently refurbished and everything, so it was completely empty. And I was on the phone having hyperventilating and talking to my dad. I was like, I don't know what to do. I'm stuck in Toronto, and there's there's like 1,000 people in this hallway where I can't walk around, and I don't know where to go. None of my friends are answering the phone, so I don't know where they are, and it just kept. So eventually, a couple of people I knew were coming in from Alberta, and they were on the later flight.
So what were you there for again, sir? What were you there for?
I was running, I was doing a security team for Anime North.
Oh, okay. Anyway,
it was my 19th birthday.
Oh, wow. Yeah, that's pretty frightening.
It's also the one where, I was like, we finished the convention, we had one more day in the city, which was my birthday, which we were going to hang out for a little bit, and then they were going to go back to Saskatoon. I was going to go visit my grandmother.
Right.
They left at 4 o'clock in the morning when I was asleep.
Oh, that's very nice. Oh,
they knew it was my birthday.
So they're not friends anymore?
Yeah,
assume?
Really.
Well, no.
Yeah, pretty much.
Legitimately, yeah, that's
a
fucking dickhole thing.
The other thing is, the other fear, which is makes it very hard for me to trust people all the time, is the fact that I've been stabbed in the back by so many people I considered my friends.
Mm-hmm.
I've been abandoned, completely forgotten, and everything like that. So the other one is, just being treated like I don't exist.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. No, that's shitty.
I'm so thankful I don't treat you like that.
Mm-hmm.
No, really.
But that was, that was my best friend. He didn't talk to me for over a year and a half.
Yeah. So much of a friend there, right? Yeah.
Yeah, and and then after he broke up with this bitch of an ex who I was nothing but friendly and kind towards, apparently she felt burned by me.
You gotta love that feeling, though.
Yeah, it was great. And then we almost had a complete falling out. We meet occasionally, we talk, but it's nowhere near.
Not the same.
I met him.
He
tried to crush my hand in a handshake. I didn't give him that honor.
But that's the thing is, too, is like after he broke up with his ex there, he actually told me, and I think I told you this too.
You told me, yep.
Is that we drove out and we were talking, and it was just like the first time after he broke up that we actually saw each other in a year and a half.
Mm.
And he was like, I wish I never met Brittany because I probably would have ended up with you. And I didn't realize how much you actually meant to me, and I just finally realized that I'm in love with you.
Oh.
And I was like,
yeah.
It's a shame you didn't tell me that a year ago, because
yeah, really.
6 months after you stopped talking to me, I realized I loved you too.
Oh, there you go.
So I was like, we had this giant kind of falling out where it's like, are we even friends anymore? And I was completely honest with him. I was like, our interactions were extremely strained because
It was a hard
I told him that exactly what always constantly happened with all my friends. And he did the exact same thing as everyone else did.
Wow.
So he completely broke my trust there.
Yeah. No, I will not do that for you.
There you go. No.
I don't want to get along.
Yeah, those are all very legitimate fears, Alex. Jesus. Way to bring down the show. No, I'm kidding.
You asked what my fears are. I know.
I asked for it. It's fine.
You asked for it.
They're good.
They're depressing, too.
See, I'm just afraid of dog-sized spider-sized
dogs.
What kind of dog-sized spiders? I'm afraid of dog-sized spiders, and you're afraid of real things. Anyway, what are you afraid of, sir?
I'm afraid of creationists and falling.
Fucking creationists.
Not Scientologists or
pretty much the same fucking retards.
Yeah. Are you creationists afraid? In power. They terrify the shit out of me.
I get so are you afraid of falling creationists then?
Like no, fall, that would be great.
Like no, that'd be,
oh no, I'd push them.
Fair enough, man. Fair enough.
Okay, yours, what are your other
yours
two?
Are simple. What am I looking
for? You still have to come back to you for the third one.
Well, no. Yeah.
That's two. I'm thinking about the third one.
You're thinking about
the
third one? Literally.
See, it took me no time at all to think.
No.
I'm not really scared of a whole lot. Like, other than, like, falling or my kids falling or something.
Yeah. Like, basically, yeah. Like, I'm afraid of heights, so that's my one for sure that we talked about quick. And then my other one would probably, I mean, the legitimate spiders. I am afraid of spiders, really? But if it really came down to it, I'd fight a giant dog-sized spider.
I would.
If it came down to it, I would. No, honestly, I think the other thing, like, obviously, this is going to sound lame and cliche or whatever, but yeah, something, if anything was to happen to my kid or, you know, something like that, it's
taken.
That's actually literally legitimate. It's like, if something was to happen to her that I don't know what happened, that's the worst thing.
The one thing I hear is like I look at this is sort of really going to an extreme here, but I look at like the situation of like Catholic priests and things like that.
Fuck.
And I think of like,
and how that kid will never fucking tell you until they're
an adult, there's something seriously wrong with them, and you take them to counseling, and then they open up and say, oh yeah, the priest raped me. It's like
holy shit, like
stuff like that, where your mm-hmm. kid is like, you have no awareness of the damage that's been done to your child.
Well, I was never gonna tell my parents either, to be completely honest.
Yeah, fair enough.
You always expect your parents or the people you love to explode it more than to make it, not make it worse, but to make it, it's already worse enough, and to make it even worse than that.
The reason why I didn't want to tell my parents is I didn't want them to look at me the way everyone else was looking at me.
Fair enough.
And it was a stupid mistake where I forgot my debit card and we were at the hospital and I was hungry. So, and I paid with the MasterCard. And guess who got the bill?
Yeah.
I did remember.
I wasn't going to tell them because they asked, why didn't you tell us? Because I didn't want you to look at me the way you're looking now.
Fair enough.
I did kind of remember my third fear.
What is it?
And Alex knows it because I deal with it on a fucking monthly basis at least.
Mm.
What is it?
This is like the extreme version of New England Kids.
What is the one thing that I fight with almost every time?
Okay, we hit the timer right here, so what is it?
Me leaving.
To this day, because I've had three girlfriends drop my ass at a hat when I thought everything was going good, to this day, if I don't hear from Alex in a couple of days, I start freaking out. I start going, oh, fuck, she's going to drop me. She doesn't want to fucking talk to me anymore. And everything could be fine. Everything is fine.
And everything
fine,
is fine. Trust me, I've had the talks with them. I don't think I did something wrong. It's like, you always do something wrong, I say, but I doubt she'll leave. No.
Yeah, and it's just, and I'm getting over it, but it's still a fear. It still grips me every once in a while. I'm like, I didn't see you for a whole week this last round.
I was busy.
Yeah, and that's fine. No, and I'm not.
She does have a life.
And I didn't freak out.
It was like, I was preparing for a wood turning event. I
didn't
have time. No, she's just handling a lot of knobs, man. Leave her alone.
A lot of pens.
I just had to make a wood joke.
Anyway,
okay, so, yeah.
But I handled it fine this time. It's just sometimes,
because I warned you like 2 weeks in advance.
So I will not be contacting you. okay.
Yeah, no, it's just...
it's like, well, we're not going to hang out this week. I got to do this, this, and I got to do this, and I got to do this so I can do this all weekend.
But it is something, it is a fear of mine. It's a fear that I didn't think of until just now.
Fear of rejection.
Not so much rejection that I'm going to be the last person to know about my fucking this, about this. Like, I'm not going to feel... Because with the other girlfriends, we didn't even fucking fight. It's just one day, yeah, sorry, maybe you... Where the fuck did this come from? We were happy 5 minutes ago. What the fuck?
No, it's that 4 minutes, man. Okay. So you?
Well, what's your favorite? I can't think of a third one, but I will lighten the mood by telling you my father's greatest fear.
Oh, what's that?
Geese.
Good old Canada.
Seriously? Eh?
That's understandable. It's like, very understandable.
What's Charlie towards you? That is kind of crazy.
It's like, what? With one wing beat, they can break your arm, man. Yeah.
There's one story. Mason was, I think he was 4 years old at the time.
Right.
And we were at the forestry farm. Or the western, or what was it? The zoo.
It is, yeah.
The zoo.
Yeah.
Forestry farm.
Yeah,
called,
yeah, the forestry farm. And we're walking along, and there's this big flock of geese walking just along that. My dad literally takes his 4-year-old son and puts him between him and the
holy shit!
My mom yelled, "You mad? Don't put your fucking son between
him." You know what I've determined with geese? Canadian geese, you know what it is?
Basically, it's almost a folly too.
Never approach them after they've had a chick.
Yeah. Yeah. No, but
yeah,
here,
that's what they
here's
do
what
say,
I've determined with geese. Since Canada is such a nice nation in general,
all of our assholes,
the hatred's got to go somewhere.
And it goes to the geese.
Geese are Canada's embodiment of hatred.
The hatred. There you
they're
go.
The hatred. Yes.
God said, "What can I make? Let's make a bird that's majestic and beautiful. But let's make it a complete asshole."
We have a pot.
With the nicest people ever. There you go.
Yeah. I have this country named Canada now, and I have all this hatred I have to put in it. But I can't put it in the people. They're so nice.
They're so nice.
I'm putting all this fucking bird.
Pretty much. And geese are beautiful. They are majestic, beautiful creatures. Yep. But that doesn't mean I don't want to shoot them with a shotgun every spring or every season.
The raw, passionate hatred of the Canadian goose.
On that note,
till next time, I'm Big Mike.
I guess Sam Impossible.
I'm Alex.
And I'm Justin Ferguson.
And watch out for the fucking geese, man.
They should make a horror movie about geese.
They're probably.